सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द ज्योमेट्री ऑफ स्क्वायर्स एंड रेक्टेंगल्स. सो फॉर सम ऑफ यू दिस माइट कम एज अ वेरी इजी टॉपिक एंड यू माइट टेंड टू इग्नोर दिस. यू विल से दैट व्हाट इज देयर टू स्टडी, वी ऑलरेडी नो यू नो थिंग्स. बट ट्रस्ट यू मी, दिस एंटायर यू नो टॉपिक ऑफ मेंसुरेशन ऑफ स्क्वायर्स एंड रेक्टेंगल्स इज बेस्ड ऑन लाइक two or three formulas, but the kind of questions that have been asked will, you know, require the concept from the entire mensuration part. So don't think that squares and rectangles are an easy portion, I should ignore this, what's there to study. So don't have any such notions. So you will immediately realize by the kind of questions that have been asked that you need to be in practice. So what are the formulas, what are the basic most formulas that you must be knowing when it comes to the mensuration or the geometry of squares? So to begin with, let's draw a square and then see how things turn out. So what all things must a student be aware of when it comes to the geometry of squares? So basic most thing that you all know, that all four sides of the square are equal. So if one side is denoted by a, length a, the other three sides are a as well, and this angle is 90 degrees, so this basic you know. So let's develop upon this basic. So what will be the diagonal of a square in terms of a? So you can find that out by applying Pythagoras theorem. So if this side of the square is a, this also must be equal to a, and this angle is already known to be 90 degrees. So the diagonal of a square is actually, if you look properly, the hypotenuse of this triangle. So if you find that out applying Pythagoras theorem, what will the diagonal come out to be? Diagonal then comes out to be equal to under root of a square plus a square. So this is equal to a root 2. So the next time you are given the value of side, then you can say that diagonal is root 2 times the side in case of a square. So root 2 times of side. In case of square, please remember we are discussing square, not rectangle. Now what else you must be knowing? That the diagonals of the square, they intersect at an angle of 90 degrees. They not only intersect, in fact they bisect. What is the difference between intersecting and bisecting? Bisecting means dividing into two equal parts. So this part is equal to this part, similarly this part is equal to this part. It got dissected, broken into two equal parts. So if I ask you to calculate, let's say this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is O. So angle DOC is equal to 90 degrees, because the diagonals intersect at an angle of 90 degrees. And if I ask you to find length of DA, so length of DA is what? Half of diagonal, so half of A root 2. So all these tips and tricks will come handy to you when you will get into solving the questions. One more thing that you must know before you dive deep into solving these questions. So let's move to that first. So the concept that I would like to discuss now is the concept of basic proportionality. So basic proportionality, as you have already studied in when we were discussing triangles. So a few application or few questions based on the basic proportionality theorem are also coupled with the concepts of triangle and rectangle. So let's revisit the concept here as well. What is meant by basic proportionality theorem? So I will revisit in terms of triangles, then we will look how it translates to the realm of rectangles and squares. So let us understand what basic proportionality theorem was. Suppose this is a quadrilateral, all the angles are, let this be a parallelogram. So I am not saying that all the angles are 90 degree, but this is a parallelogram. What do you mean by parallelogram? Opposite sides are parallel. So this is a parallelogram. So what is the concept of basic proportionality? So let's suppose this entire base is divided into three equal parts, and you draw this triangle, this one, and let me name it A, B, C, D, and E. So area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle CDE can be figured out. So as I said that this has been trisected, so this is 1:1:1. So area of a triangle is what? Half into base into height. So if you translate this properly, this will be half into base. Base is what? BC into height. Let height be denoted by H. Similarly, area of triangle CDE can then be written as half into base. Base is what? CE. Height will be same height because both the triangles are drawn on same base. So if the base is same, that means if a few triangles are drawn between same parallel lines, then as you can see that the ratio of their areas is actually the ratio of their bases. What do we mean? Let me generalize this. So these are two parallel lines, and if you are drawing two triangles, so if you draw two triangles between the same set of parallel lines, so you are doing one thing, that you are keeping the height same for both the triangles. So if height is same for both the triangles, so as per the formula, the area, the ratio of area must be the same as the ratio of their bases. Now this concept is applied to frame questions from squares and rectangles. How? So this is a common favorite strategy of the question setters, that they will draw a square like this. So drawing a square means a square is also a parallelogram. So they will draw a square, then they will break one side of the square in certain parts, let's say four parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. So now they will draw a few triangles, or let's say they will ask you to find the ratio of this triangle to the entire let's say this triangle, let me name it A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Then how are you going to solve this? So now if I ask you to find the ratio of area of triangle ABD to that of the entire square, let's suppose entire square ABGF, then what can you do? So base, now please remember, square is made up of two equal triangles, as you can see here. So you can begin from that. So if this is 1:1:1:1, that means you have already decided that the side of the square is what? 4:4:16. So side of the square comes out to be 16. So side of square being equal to 4, area comes out to be 16. 4 square 16. And then you can find the area of the triangle using half into base into height. So such kind of questions, such kind of strategies you would be required to employ. So now let's move to the example, the kind of questions that have been asked over previous years. So we have made a collection of all those questions so that you can practice the concept and questions side by side. So what do? We teach a concept and then followed by its question, so that it immediately you can realize that in what way are those concepts to be applied. So now let's move to solved example. So here is the first one. If length of side of a square is increased by 8 centimeters, its area increases by 120 square centimeter. So what is the length of the side of the square? So what is being said? So let's suppose the original length or original side of a square be A. So what is being done? The length is increased by 8. So earlier it was A, now it becomes a plus 8. So what was the area? Earlier the area was side square, that means a square. Now the area becomes a plus 8 whole square. So it is being said that the area increases by 120 centimeters. So area increases, that means new area minus old area is the increase in area. So this is given to us as 120 units. So let's solve this. So if you expand this, this will come out to be a square plus 8 square, that means 64, plus 2 into 8, that means 16a minus a square is given to be equal to 120. So this a square and this a square gets cancelled. From here you can see that 16a is equal to 56. So from here you can see that a comes out to be 56 upon 16. Both are cancelable by 4, or better still by 8. So 7 by 2. So this is 3.5 centimeters. This is the correct answer. So now let's move forward. The product of length of the diagonals of a square is a is 50 square units. So what is the length of the side of the square? So as I already told you that if one side of a square is assumed to be a, its diagonal comes out to be a root 2. So now what is being said? The product of the length of the diagonals. So how many diagonals does a square has? It has two diagonals and both are equal in length. So it is saying diagonal 1 into diagonal 2, the product of the diagonal is 50. So it means a root 2 multiplied by a root 2 is given as 50. So from here you can find out that a comes out to be, or let's take step by step, a square into 2 is equal to 50. So from here a square is equal to 25, or a is equal to 5. That means one side of the square comes out to be of 5 centimeter length. So once you have found out, you have the answer 5. So let's move to the next one. So questions are going to get complicated as we proceed. So please do not skip, do not ignore, because all the questions that you are looking at have actually been asked in exam. So don't think that we are picking some random questions. So these are the kind of questions that you will expect. And sometimes it's all about the time, who solves in the lesser amount of time. So questions might be easy, but you might be employing a method which takes more amount of time. So kindly do not skip. So now what is this question? The ratio of area of a square to that of a square drawn on its diagonal is. So let's suppose this is a square. Then this will be its diagonal. So the question is, if you assume this diagonal to be the side of another square and then you draw that square, so you have to tell us the ratio of these two squares. That means the original square to the newly formed square, the ratio of their area. So let's do that. So if the side of the original square is equal to a, then the length of this diagonal will be equal to a root 2. That means you already have the magnitude of the sides of these two squares. So now let's find their area. So area is what? Side square. So area of the original square is a square, because its side was equal to a. What is the area of the newly formed square? As its side is a root 2, so its area will be a root 2 whole square. So basically we have to find the ratio of these two numbers. That means a square by a square into 2, because root 2 whole square is 2. So answer is what? 1 is to 2. So these kind of options are meant to make you commit mistakes. So answer is 1 is to 2. So please be careful. Some students might solve correctly, but while marking they may mark the wrong option. So please keep such pitfalls in mind. So let's see this question. A square is inscribed in a right angle triangle with legs P and Q. Legs means perpendicular and base, and has a common right angle with triangle. The diagonal of the square is given by which of these expressions? So let us draw the diagram, then you can understand this in a better way. So this is the right angle triangle ABC, and as you can see, a square DEFB is drawn within it, inscribed. So this is the given data. This is P, this entire length is P, this entire base is Q, and then you have drawn a square. So let one side of the square be equal to A. So this is what is given. So let this much be equal to A. So this entire thing is equal to P, and this height or perpendicular is equal to Q, legs. So now we have to find, or we have to express diagonals in terms of P and Q. That means whatever answer you will have to give, the answer can involve only P and Q, these two variables. So how can we do that? Let's understand. So you see, please remember for once and all. So whenever such situation is created that within a right angle triangle, a square is inscribed. So basically, whosoever has framed the question, he wants you to apply the concept of similarity. Now look at triangles ADE and the bigger triangle ABC. So look at these two triangles. So this angle is common in both the triangles. And look at this angle. This angle is 90 degree for the smaller triangle, and this angle is 90 degree for the bigger triangle. So you can see that in these two triangles, two angles are exactly equal. So if two angles are equal, that means all the three angles are equal to each other. So these two triangles are similar. So if these two triangles are similar, then you can say that AD by AB must be equal to DE by BC. Now please see what will be the value of AD. So this entire length is Q, and DB, that means up till here it is A, so the remaining part is Q minus A. So AD is what? Q minus A divided by AB. AB is Q, must be equal to DE. DE is what? Equal to A divided by BC. BC is what? P. So if you solve this, what do you get? If you cross multiply, QP plus AP is equal to AQ. So this will be minus AP. So from here, QP is equal to, if taken that side, it becomes A into P plus Q. So from here you can see that A, or the side of the square in terms of P and Q, can be written to be A is equal to PQ divided by P plus Q. So this is the side of the square, but we have been asked to find the diagonal of the square, not side. So side came out to be equal to PQ divided by P plus Q. So diagonal is what? Diagonal is root 2 times of side. So answer will be root 2 times of PQ divided by P plus Q. So which is the correct answer? This is the correct one. Let's move further. So let's see what this question is about. The corner of a square of side A are cut away so as to form a regular octagon. What is the side of the octagon? So let's draw a diagram, then things will become much clearer. So this is the square sheet of paper from which these corners, these portions are cut out. So these four portions are cut out. So if you cut this out, what will be the shape of the paper left behind? The shape of the paper that will be left behind will be something like this, will be like a octagon. So this is the meaning of the question, that corners were cut out to form a regular octagon. And what is a regular octagon? regular octagon or any regular polygon for that matter, when you use the term regular, it means that all the sides are of same measurement. So as you can see, the octagon is regular. So if the octagon is regular, that's why all these sides are denoted of equal length. So if this side is of length x, this side is also of length x of octagon. Similarly, this side is also of length x. Now, let as it is already given that the side of the square was equal to a. So this entire length was equal to a. From that, this length, this is the length of the side of the octagon. So suppose this is a, and let me not call it a because this is a is already used. So let me call it x, again not x. So p, m and n. So now concentrate on triangle npm. So np must be equal to what? Now you see np, so this length is equal to this length, symmetry. So np will be equal to a minus x by 2, because this entire length is a. If you remove x and divide it into two parts, it's like a minus x by 2. So np is equal to pm due to symmetry, regular. Now concentrate in triangle npm. In triangle npm, these two sides are equal. These two sides, this side is equal to this side. So the diagonal will be root 2 times the side. So side is what? A minus x by 2. So this is a minus x by 2. This is also a minus x by 2. So this is the diagonal. So diagonal is root 2 times, because if you complete this, this will also become a square. So diagonal into root 2 must be equal to x. So from here you can see that a minus x is by root 2 is equal to x. So from here, if you will solve, a is equal to x into root 2 plus 1. So a comes out to be equal to, so a is equal to x into root 2 plus 1. So from here, if you want to express x, which is the side of the octagon, you would say that x is equal to a divided by root 2 plus 1. But the problem is none of the options match. So have we solved wrongly? No, we have not solved wrongly. It's just that options are represented in some other format. So if you rationalize this, if you rationalize this by multiplying by root 2 minus 1, it gets rationalized, and then you will see that one of the options start matching. So x is equal to, you rationalize. So root 2 plus 1 into root 2 minus 1 is what? It's like a plus b into a minus b. So a square, that means 2 minus b square, that means 2 square minus 2 minus 1, 1. So x comes out to be a into root 2 minus 1. So this is the correct answer.